Hello guys, my name is Amit Saini and I welcome you in this 5th November daily UPSC MCQ lesson. In the evening, we discuss these important issues daily and important sources like PIB, EPW magazine, other important magazine, Yojana Kurukshetra and newspapers, websites, everything we prefer here. And these questions are going to help you a lot in the next year's prelims. So keep following these lessons. And in the morning, the Hindu Rals videos, they come. So follow both the lessons religiously. 5th of November it is. Let's start. Paid content is available at 159 rupees per month. And you will not have any issue in joining that because these numbers are given. You can call on these numbers here. And all the queries, all the issues will be solved. All these pen drive courses are also available. And you can also inquire about them on these same numbers here. Okay, PDF you will get here on Telegram channel, which is given here on this Facebook group. So you can send me a request there and you can follow me on Instagram too. First question, oligomannate is the drug for. It's a famous drug. In 2003, it was firstly approved for a particular disease, and that disease is not cancer, not measles, not Parkinson's, it is Alzheimer's. Although all are important ones and all are very much haunting disease for whole world, but Alzheimer's is something very unique. Means a lot of researchers are going on, and on a war scale we all are trying to find solutions for, because a lot of old people are struggling with that. And it is not only old people, some young ones are also affected. Brain cells, they are damaged. Actual cause, nobody knows about that. So a lot of research is going on, but it is the major cause of dementia there, means the memory loss. But Alzheimer's, you must have watched a movie there, Ajay Devgan Kajol's movies there, and they discuss that issue of Alzheimer's there. So that's a typical one. And regarding that, China has approved the first homegrown drug oligomannate GV971 for the treatment of mild to moderate Alzheimer's disease. And it is the first drug to be approved for Alzheimer's disease globally since 2003. So that's important. It's an irreversible progressive brain disorder that slowly destroys memory and thinking skills and eventually the ability to carry out the simplest tasks. In the end, the person is totally stuck, and after that everything becomes impossible, means the life becomes impossible in the later stages. So that's why we want to make it a reversible problem. We want to have the cure there, but when the brain cells are damaged, then the cure is very, very difficult. But this drug oligomannate can be a solution there. Next, Dhanush. Yesterday we talked about that. Dhanush is the artillery gun. It's a modernized one. And what is the main upgrade there? The existing ones, they are having 105 mm ammunition system. It has 155 mm. And that we are trying to get for the last 2-3 decades. Now we have developed that. Indigenously we have developed that. It's a upgraded variant of Swedish Bofors gun. Range is 36 km, so this is correct. Next, M777 that we acquired last year. We acquired it from not Russia, it is USA. It was the first modern artillery gun system that we procured there. So M777 howitzer was the ultralight artillery gun. I explained this issue in my PIB videos a few months back, so that you can refer there. Only one is the correct option here. Second is wrong, because M777 is taken from USA, not Russia. From Russia, we have taken S-400 missile defense system. Okay, these details are very, very important, because these are all modern issues. We are in a dire need of these modernization, and we are procuring things from developed countries. So they are very important. So from Israel, from Russia, from America, whatever we are procuring, these are very important. M777 we took from USA. And K9 Vajra we took from South Korea, S-400 from Russia. Okay, and this Dhanush we have indigenously developed. Ordnance Factory Board has developed that. Okay, Lingam Monastery, President of India recently visited that. It's a important Buddhist center there, and these all monasteries are located in hilly states of India, in the Himalayan states. So Himachal Pradesh, there are important monasteries. In Ladakh also there are monasteries. In Sikkim also, in AP also. But the answer is Sikkim. It's an important example of Buddhist architecture also. A huge Buddha statue is built there. So Sikkim is the right answer here. C is the right answer. Rangka is the place in Sikkim where this Lingdam monastery is located. And Zurmang Kangyu sect has the following there. It's an ancient school of Tibetan Buddhism. Okay, it's an important pilgrimage center and the gigantic statue of Lord Buddha. It's enshrined at the end of the hall there. That's the issue. Next, regarding the APSPA issue, JNK and Ladakh, they have become separate union territories now. So under the center they are, but the APSPA, what's going to happen with that? It started in India in 1950s and since 1990s in Kashmir, it is applicable there. Till now it was a state, now they are union territories. So how these will be managed? So that's the important question. UPSC certainly can ask you this question. The Union Cabinet Secretariat has notified regarding Armed Force Special Powers Act in JNK and Ladakh. So they have notified regarding that, but who will be the authority on deciding the imposition of APSPA in Union Territories of Jammu and Kashmir? So the answer is what? These powers can be given to LGs, but it is not. They can be there with the president also, because the whole matter is under center now, but it is also wrong. They can be there with the PMO also. It's a most sensitive area for security. But the answer is MHA. MHA is gonna decide about the APSPA issue in Jammu and Kashmir. So it's a very relevant question. D is the right answer here. Okay, you can see the details are given here. APSPA in JNK and Ladakh. MHA will be the authority on deciding the imposition of APSPA in a manner there. Next, India and which country have launched the partnership for green urban mobility issue? Futuristic issue, we need these solutions today, although it is related to a particular state and a particular city there, but these initiatives are very important today. So this green urban mobility partnership to reform bus sector in Tamil Nadu. So the answer is Germany. These bilateral relations, they're also signified by these kind of initiatives. So when you discuss the international relations and the bilateral relations, then also these things are important. Prime examples these are, so you can write about that. And these are the solution giving modern measures, that's why they are important. So answer is Germany. Indo-German partnership for green urban mobility, and where? In Tamil Nadu, especially in Chennai. They are gonna replace these existing diesel buses with electric public transport buses. So that's an important development. They are setting aside 200 million euros each, India and Germany both. So that's important. Next, National Waterway 2. Where it is located? On which river? It can be on a particular stretch. National Waterway 1 is there on Ganga. We all know about that. Brahmaputra is also a very important river. Krishna Godavari. All are involved there in these National Waterway programs. IWI is the main implementing agency there. But Waterway 2 is located on Brahmaputra. It's a 891 kilometer long stretch there, and starts from Sadia in Assam to Dhubri. Dhubri is near Indo-Bangladesh border. So what was the issue? First ever movement of container cargo on Brahmaputra Waterway 2 begins, and the journey of a container took place between Haldia dock complex to the IWI terminal at Pandu in Guwahati. It's a 12 to 15 days voyage and will be an integrated IWT movement via Waterway 1, then National Waterway 97 through Sundarbans, then Indo-Bangladesh Protocol route and Waterway 2. So IBP route is also very important. Both countries have decided about that, India and Bangladesh. Here you can see Brahmaputra River. These are important tributaries. Just try to name all these rivers. And you can see Dhubri is here. It is the border for Bangladesh. Dhubri, it is Sadia here. Okay, so from here the Brahmaputra starts and 891 kilometers, and this is Dhubri. Here India and Bangladesh using the Indo-Bangladesh protocol routes. So that how that route is important. You see, this route extends from Kolkata, India, where National Waterway 1 is there. Okay, because it is the Ganga and mainly the Haldia River. Sorry, the Haldia port and Hooghly River. So National Waterway 1, then to Silghat, which is there in Assam, on National Waterway 2, which is there in Brahmaputra, and then Karimganj Assam on Waterway 16, River Barak. You see, River Barak is very important. From Assam, it enters into eastern Bangladesh, Barak River. Hairpin band, this is famous for. So here this IBP route is there. So that is also involved there. And please go through this important detail there, because the exim trade and all these container movements, they are rising with the time. Okay, it has grown from 5.48 million tons to 6.79 million tons within 1 year. So that's important. National Institute of Ocean Technology, NIOT. It is under which ministry? Ministry of Shipping? No, it is Ministry of Earth Sciences. If you remember, Deep Ocean Mission was regarding the polymetallic nodules and finding many other resources in the ocean and other important researchers, other important ships. So for all those issues, Deep Ocean Mission was there. Ministry of Earth Science was taking that initiative. We discussed about that a few weeks back. So NIOT is going to be the nodal institution for implementing that proposed Deep Ocean Mission. Okay, we are given the permission there to find those polymetallic nodules in Indian Ocean there. So NIOT is going to implement that, and it is under Ministry of Earth Sciences. So only two is the correct option here. First is wrong. You can see in 1993 it was established as an autonomous society under Ministry of Earth Sciences, nodal institution for implementing the proposed Deep Ocean Mission. This NIOT has developed niche technologies to mine manganese nodules, which are also called polymetallic nodules, PMNs, for deep sea. It has developed several deep sea systems like remotely operable vehicles, and striving hard to bring India on par with the developed nations in area of ocean technology. So that's very, very important organization. Regarding the Deep Ocean Mission, the details are given here. Okay, so that's an important issue. India was the first country in the world to have been given the pioneer area for exploration of deep sea minerals. Okay, this polymetallic nodules, which are there in abundance in central Indian Ocean basin. And it was 1987 when we were given this permission there. So that's important lesson today. We will meet again tomorrow. Thanks a lot. Keep watching. It was Amit Sen.